Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Meena from Bangalore Institute of Technology. I'll be very happy to share my feelings here. First thing, very happy to see you all from different parts of Bangalore and Karnataka and also the other states of our country. So the FDP program conducted today on the human values is so much important that we being born as human being, it's very much important for us to understand what the human values are. Among the many values, the collective values, as a human being one has to follow in order to strengthen the society, the human values is the most required one. So the human value, what we call now, is not a new word. It is always has the title humanity. So this humanity, the search for the humanity in the society is not the cry of today. Is not the awareness which has to be created today. It goes way back. For example, we have all heard of UDHR, Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which came way back when all the abuse for the human life happened in the World War I and World War II. That was the origination which took place. And in 1948 or so, on December 10th, it got proclaimed. And that is where the awareness on the humanity and the humanity values, in turn, what we call as the human rights, started. And later on, so many conventions came, covenants came, and later treaties came, and lot of international commissions and national commissions, so many of them came in order to enrich the human values in terms of the humanity, because we are human beings in the society. But however, unless it is supported by some constitutional, say the backup or the legislative, it will not be so easily implemented. Because whatever the UDHR gave regarding the humanity or the human values, that was a mere recommendation. In order to implement that, we wanted all this support. So later on it took well, and that is how, that is where in 1948 it happened, and our India was framing our constitution, and that is why the part 3 and part 4 of our constitution is enriched highly upon the fundamental rights of a person. That is the influence of UDHR, Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Anyhow, but however, even in spite of having all that, in order to climb for these human values or the humanity or whatever the human rights, we also needed to be recognized. All this has to be recognized in terms of legislature only. That is somewhere around the Human Rights Act 1998. Gave us the liberation or gave us the independence or gave us the right where you could climb through the judicial appealings were possible. The same way, what the human values, what we are feeling, it is declining in our society. So now we are trying to inculcate and install in our society through the education institutions. So it is a very nice program which is taken up by the MHRD, which is propagated through AICTE and UGC colleges. It's a very nice attempt, one has to appreciate. And we being the teachers, where we address a very large community like the students, and they are also the very young minds of our country, we are lucky to address them, and they are selecting these educational institutions as the instruments to inculcate the human values in the society. But however, there was a lot of debate even to include this human value as a curriculum. So many discussions went on. I remember in 2016 it became legalized. Our Honorable Supreme Court gave us an verdict that this human values can be part of education or part of the syllabus. So it will not say shall, it says, it will not say shall be, it says that it can be. It can be the part of syllabus or whatever the curriculum, when it was something, the suit between Santosh Singh versus Union of India. So then the 2017 UGC took up this, and later in 2018 this whatever our AICTE has taken up. It is a very nice appreciation which is done by the MHRD of our country, so which has to be taken responsibility by us. And and we learned so many things, because we know what is humanity, what is human rights from the laws and constitutions, but how do we interpret it? How do we put that to the student? But this FDP helped us so much. These two resource persons, and I don't want to call them as speakers, because today's order where the humanity value is so much necessary in the society, I just want to address, call them as missionaries who are doing a very good job, but we have to appreciate their work, and they're doing with all so much wholeheartedly that it is reaching us and we are enjoying this. And the take back from this will be very large for us, that we are now left with a very big responsibility with this FDP. It has appeared in us what is the responsibility we have on the student community, because we are the only luckier person, teachers are the only luckier persons who can address the young minds of every country. So we have such a very large, this one, a big responsibility on us, and we have to do it, and definitely we will do it. And thanks to MHRD, and coming to the this one, facility provided by the ACS college is very tremendous. Food was very nice, very happy. So what catched the more eye-catching ear and more attention drawing in this college is the posters they have displayed on the walls. Very nice. So one day we'll take permission from our principal sir and come in the morning, stay till evening and read all the walls and so inspiring. So inspiring. So that is how we put our things out. We have so many things in our mind. But how do we put? So the media is very important. However, FDP was created as a very good and tremendous chance where we are also availed with what the responsibility we have in us. Thanks, thank you all, and thank you for giving me this.